Good day, my students. God bless you. I hope you are doing good. Today, we are going to look at healing miracles of Jesus Christ under the ministry of Peter. The last time we spoke about the ministry of Peter, his visit to Samaria, today we are going to look at the healing miracles of Peter. Peter was one of the disciples, the one that Jesus Christ said is going to hold the pillar of the church. And he was one of the disciples of Jesus Christ that walked towards the ministry, that is the message of the life and teachings of Jesus Christ to the Gentiles, in order for the Gentiles to accept Jesus Christ as the Lord. And when he did this, he went to Lydda and Joppa. Now, Lydda and Joppa were the cities we have right there in the Gentiles land. Apart from Paul, Peter also embarked on what we call a missionary journey to the Gentiles land too. So he went to Lydda and to see the brethren there, how they were doing, and how to receive the Holy Spirit too, the new converts there. And when he got there, he met with a man called Aeneas. And this Aeneas was had been bedridden for 8 years. And when he saw the man, he spoke to the man. He came to his mind and he spoke to the man, "You have been healed in the name of Jesus. You are healed in the name of Jesus." And when he spoke to him, he said, "Rise and walk." And from there, the man stood up, called Aeneas, that had been bedridden for 8 years. The man stood up and he started walking. And the people there were amazed. And a lot of people accepted Jesus Christ as the Lord right there in Joppa and Sharon. I'm talking about the territories, right? The territories we have around Lydda there. The territories we have around Lydda, that is Lydda and Sharon. Something happened when he was still with the brethren right there in Lydda. Something happened in Joppa. Right there in Joppa, something happened. There was a woman called Tabitha. Tabitha means Dorcas. He was the woman that had been giving a lot to the widows and to the needies. And she was so kind. She involved in what we call the ministry of kindness, that is giving out to the needies. And she fell sick and she died. After her death, they washed her body and they laid her right there at the upper room for the burial. But some brethren believed that this woman was supposed not to die this time around, and they sent two men to Peter right there in Lydda in order to speak to him, in order to come around to pray for the woman called Dorcas, Tabitha. And when they traveled, they spoke to him and he followed them. And when they came there, he met a lot of widows crying. We have some people at the window side. We have some people showing everything that he had done for them. We have some showing the clothes he made for them. And with this clothing and everything, he felt that this woman supposed to be alive. I'm talking about Peter now. And when Peter saw them, he asked them to move out. I'm talking about the widows and the people that were crying there. He asked them to move out. And when they moved out, the next thing he did, he knelt down and he prayed to the Lord Jesus. And when he prayed, something happened. He spoke to the dead body of Tabitha. And when he spoke to the dead body of Tabitha, that is called Dorcas now, he told the body, "Tabitha, rise." And when she heard this, she sat up. And when she sat up, she looked at Peter, and Peter stretched forth his hand. And when Peter stretched forth his hand, then he tried to pull her up. Then when Peter pulled her up, then he handed her to the saints. And from there, a lot of people were converted on that day that Peter did this right there in Joppa. That is after raising Sabita, the woman called Dorcas, right there, the woman that involved in the ministry of kindness. All right. In our next class, we are going to talk more on the ministry of Peter to the Gentiles. God bless you. We are going to talk about conversion of Cornelius. Conversion of Cornelius. Just stay back. All right. In the next class, we see. Then we continue this class right there in the Google class. Please make sure you do all your work. I'm talking about the class activity. God bless you. Bye for now.